Hi, my name is Jiala Z. I'm from Santa Clara, California. And my question is to Charlie and Warren. Given the rise of disruptive technologies that can improve productivity significantly, and AI being one of them, how do you envision the future of value investing in this new era? And what adaptations or new principles do you think investors should adopt? And any recommendations for investors to remain successful in this rapid changing landscape? Thank you.
Well, I'm glad to take that one. I think value investors are going to have a harder time now that there's so many of them competing for a diminished bunch of opportunities. So my advice to value investors is to get used to making less.
And Charlie has been telling me the same thing the whole time we've known each other. I mean, we get along wonderfully because...
But we are making less.
Yeah, well, but that's because that mostly, I think, is because it's larger.
When we were younger. And was...
Now, we never thought we could manage $508 billion.
No,
or
what,
or five, but I would argue that there's going to be plenty of opportunities. And part of the reason there are going to be plenty of opportunities, the tech doesn't make any difference or any of that. I mean, if you look at how the world's changed in the years since 1942 when I started, you'd say, well, how does a kid that doesn't know anything about airplanes, that doesn't know anything about engines and cars, and doesn't know anything about electricity and all that? But that really isn't the world changing doesn't, or new things coming along don't take away the opportunities. What gives you opportunities is other people doing dumb things. And and I would say that, well, the 58 years we've been running Berkshire, I would say there's been a great increase in the number of people doing dumb things, and they do big dumb things, and the reason they do it to some extent is because they can get money from other people so much easier than when we started. So you could start 10 or 15 dumb insurance companies in the last 10 years, and you could become rich if you were adroit at it, whether the business succeeded or not, and the underwriters got paid, and the lawyers got paid. And that creates, if that's done on a large scale, which it couldn't be done 58 years ago, you couldn't get the money to do some of the dumb things that we wanted to do, fortunately. I think that investing has disappeared so much from this huge capitalistic market that anybody can play in, but that the big money is in selling other people ideas. It isn't outperforming. I think if you don't run too much money, which we do, but if you're running small amounts of money, I think the opportunities will be greater. But then Charlie and I have always differed on this subject. He likes to tell me how gloomy the world is, and I like to tell him we'll find something. And so far, we've both been kind of right. Charlie, wouldn't you? Will you budge an inch on that or not?
There is so much money now in the hands of so many smart people, all trying to outsmart one another and outpromote one another, getting more money out of other people. And it's a radically different world from the world we started in. And I suppose it will have its opportunities, but it's also going to have some unpleasant episodes.
But they're trying to outsmart each other in arenas that you don't have to play. I mean, if you look at that government bond market, the treasury bill market, I mean, you've got this one bill that's out of line with the others. We bought over $3 billion of it the other day. But those are people. The world is overwhelmingly short-term focused. And if you go to an investor relations call they're all trying to figure out how to fill out a sheet to show the earnings for the year. And the management is interested in feeding them expectations that will slightly be beaten. I mean, that is a world that's made to order for anybody that's trying to think about what you do that should work over 5 or 10 or 20 years. And I just think that I would love to be born today and go out with not too much money and hopefully turn it into a lot of money. But, and Charlie would too, actually. Just like he would find something to do, I will just guarantee you. And it wouldn't be exactly the same as before, but he would have a big, big, big pile.
I would not like the thrill of losing my big pile into a small pile. Well, I like my big pile just the way it is.
Well, I like. We agree on that, incidentally. Okay.
Yes, we do. You're one of the most extreme lovers of the big pile.